Hello and welcome, my name is Hugh, and this is a Let's Try series of Northgard. And this time we're gonna try out hooking and mooning the Raven clan. So obviously we got a win last time with the Clans of Wolf trying to get a conquest victory, but somehow along the way we won a trade victory, which I was thinking we were gonna do with this clan, but I guess then we're gonna go for something else with this clan. The Hooking and Mooning clan is the clan of the Raven. They're great explorers and merchants. Their mighty fleet allowed them to be the first to land on Northgard. They are strong trade partners if you don't mind their constant scheming. Rash and swift, they will often be found roaming where you least expect them. So this is a really interesting clan, and it's like I've already tried a couple of games with them, and they're really, really hard to get off the ground because they don't get any bonuses. So the clan of the goat, you get some food for free. Here you get a bunch of food for free, and you get a really easy way of keeping your happiness and money up with the skulls. Fenrir, well, you get the free happiness from your warriors, which is pretty nice because you don't have to think about getting happiness early on. Here, all you get is the ability to colonize with crowns, which means that you have to get crowns. So it's not really gonna help you that much early on. I haven't even gotten to the fame bonuses yet, but getting two villages for free is obviously nice, but not game-changing, I think. And I don't know what the mercenaries do. I guess they're some kind of warriors, so we're gonna have to see. Let's try again. But yeah, I'm definitely... I think they've fixed the... They have changed the starting algorithm so that you get one food area. But you're not guaranteed that that food area is something you can actually colonize. In my last three games, it has been an area that had either wolves or Juega in it. So you had to actually get warriors to get food. And I still think it's just too goddamn hard to get a, like, started in this game. And it's gotta be that thing where, like, okay, obviously, if it is a truly balanced start, then it's fine because, well, everyone is gonna have a hard time. But we have had games where we just had an easy start, and if you are doing a multiplayer game where you have, like, you're almost dead from the beginning, and someone else just gets food aplenty, then you lost the game before you even started it, and that's just not nice for a multiplayer game. That's kind of the opposite of what you want in a multiplayer game. You want something that's balanced and where the competition comes from going up against the others rather than just going up against the game. It's fine enough if this was a survival game, but it's not. It's a game about actually going out and fighting other Vikings. So like, see here, get food for free, the first area I look into. Like, that's really great, right? But, yeah. So, I do need to build a house here. So, just get one of the other guys to go and... Well, you go produce some wood, so we can get that building quicker. But yeah, I think it's very important that... I really like games where they do procedural generating of content, but they should do some kind of algorithm so that your starting square is predetermined. It doesn't have to be everyone gets a farm, but everyone should get one food area that they don't have to kill anyone for, and maybe one more food area that they can then, like, kill some animals and get their second food area, and then they're up and running, and then you don't have to worry about it anymore. Well, you still have to worry about it, but you don't have to, like, die right off the bat because you just didn't have any food. So down here we have a shoreline, we have a ship that we can get some money from. Here we also have stone, which is pretty nice. But not a lot of room to build on. Ironically enough, we're running out of food now. You go and gather some food for me. I don't know, maybe it's just... Maybe you're just supposed to keep a lot of workers on food, and I'm just trying to do too much in the start of the game. I don't know. It just seems to me that you're supposed to build all these buildings, because you can't really expand unless you just build a lot. You go and explore that area so I know what's around me. And you're literally gathering food on the farm without being a farmer. That's pretty. So we can't expand there. I guess what we need now is to get a training camp going. So we can get on with this. I would like this forest for some more wood. Let's see what's in this area. But yeah, I really do like this game. And that's like basically, obviously I wouldn't play it this much if I just didn't like it. I see a real potential in it. I feel like they could probably make some pretty nice campaigns in here, especially if they added some more like campaign unique buildings, stuff like that. I just don't like that it seems only one building. That's really shitty. It annoys me that I don't feel like the game is balanced. That's not really a good feeling. Let's have you go and produce some more wood for me. We'll see what we get in other areas here. Hopefully we get some more food in one of the next two areas. No fish in this lake, it would seem. Get something we can explore here. Doesn't seem like there's any. This seems like a swamp, so probably no food up there. So stone, more stone. We have stone, stone, stone. You're gonna get so stoned. Ah, that was an obvious bad joke. You go here. This was tree, yeah, so we're just gonna go kill that. I actually like another guy right away, since we're gonna kill two wolves. Of course our territory gets attacked at the same time. So let's take this area, and I think I'm gonna go for a trading post right off the bat here. Ooh. Might have to secure this iron before green takes it. And yellow is right here. Rather boxed in. We are actually completely boxed in. This area, we have to kill two Duergar to take. And then yellow is there. This one. It's brown bear. This one. Two wolves. Let's make sure we take this area. Take that from him. And let's get that trading post up and running. Yeah. we'll just keep the warrior here. So yeah, rather boxed in. We definitely need this one as well, because that's the only law we're gonna get, it seems. So we do need to get on the warrior's path pretty soon. Let's get some more money flowing in, so we can use that to buy warriors and expand. And we also need a healer's hut. We can build that down here. And we need a house. Alright, we can build a house here. Okay. Yeah. Problem with food right now, because these needs healing. So let's just let him gather some food. You should gather food. Why not gathering food? Go gather food. You become a healer because we need that. Yeah, I know that I need houses, but I don't really have the wood for it right now. Go build that house for me, and then you just, once you're done with the warrior there, let's just get a trading route going. Oh, we don't really have anything we can trade away right now. Not until the winter's over. Well, once he's done with it, I need to make sure that he doesn't have any warriors. I think they might have them down here, but let's just explore his areas. Oh, that's nice with some extra money there. Okay, so... next step, I guess, is starting some mining. I don't know how we're gonna survive this. We don't have more food access anywhere. Go for sharp axes. Go become a merchant. Okay, so you go take care of this. So we need to heal you again. So you do have warriors and you're attacking this area. And losing, so that's good. You find out what he has there. Oh, he actually has fish here. I probably need to... he has fish and the ended area. I definitely need to attack him down here. But I also do need to build a mine here. So I'm gonna get that mind. You just go and attack here. Okay, and then we can attack him and take this area from him, and we have all the food we need. I'm not gonna waste anyone on... You're gonna be a guy there. We need to attack him as soon as possible and get this area. So would we have enough? Need 80 crowns before we do it. We do need to heal him, so let's just wait for that. Might also need another warrior for that. Let's just build that house. Our explorer was hurt. He's just looking at more green. This is a brilliant area, and blue is right here. Everyone's so close on this map. Okay, almost healed. Once he's healed, go attack this area, take that over. Do we have the crowns for it now? We do. So let's have you become a warrior. Go here. Then we go and take over. He already have a fisherman here. So I guess there's only two buildings here, yeah. So we need to take the iron before we can... oh, we have to go into this area first. Well, I'm just gonna have to do that then. And he has three warriors, so let's just retreat for now and heal. It's gonna be a problem then. We do not have any happiness now. Guess we can build a brewery down here. I think we need to upgrade this one first. See, we can kill them. Oh well. Yeah. This is looking hard. Like, if we can get this area, I think we have a good chance. But it's gonna be hard. We already lost two warriors. If we could probably take Weaponsmith next. Obviously, he is the green guy, so that's not even really making it easier. Scout. Go find the yellow guy for me. Did he just kill his guys? We still have a warrior there. So we could start trading with yellow. Let's just do that. Oh, not yellow, blue. Oh, he's getting attacked by blue as well. This is perfect. As long as blue doesn't take this area from me. And he has all the iron here now, so it's ripe and ready. Let's try again. And let's get the weaponsmith. Since we are going to war. Our scout died. Brilliant. Okay, do he has? He doesn't have any warriors in there now. Let's see if we can kill these civilians before the warriors arrive. We might have made it. Just let him go and build that for me. That would be nice. Let's have... Well, they're going to help. Well, you go and heal. This is gonna be on a knife's edge. Ooh, you go and help here. And go back and heal. God damn it. He must be running out of people by now. And now two fresh warriors steps in. Now we have to wait for that again. And in the blizzard! I'm not sure we'll make it with the food. I have to see. Once the window's over, I think I'm gonna build another scout so I can scout that right there, get some money. Come on, and colonize. Might as well repair that. I would like to repair this as well, but I'm just gonna make sure that I have enough wood for that. But at least the winter is actually over when this blizzard is over, so we are gonna run out of food now. But we made it through. Just repair that. And now we have food. So now we just have to take this area as well. I think we do need to heal a little bit before we can do that. Obviously we lost this area because we didn't really pay attention over there. He already has 2 training camps. Seems like a lot. Okay, we need wood for upgrading this. So this is a forest. We could build the wood down here. But we're right to get this area first. Three fishermen and 2 hunters. Why 3 fishermen? Problem is the hunters actually do quite a lot of damage, so I need to get my guys healed. Let's just get another guy. Just what we needed. Well, if we let him go in first, lose at least one of our warriors, but we'll lose all 3. This is really, really on the edge. We've lost a lot of guys already. At least we have a lot of money. Okay, gotta get one guy on this now, so don't fall too far behind. I think we are gonna build another scout camp. We're gonna build a woodcutter's lodge here. Get someone on that. And hopefully we have enough money to... Yeah, we have 125 for this. So, and then we can just repair these and rock. Let's get erudition so we can catch up on research. Ooh, so you're done. You go and take that instead. And he's attacking over here for some weird reason. Okay. And now we just... fill up on production. Honda, fisherman. Hopefully some more guys on the way. And this is probably one of those areas where it would make sense to buy a building so we can get one of those food silos in. And you go here. Let's go and kill his warriors while they're weak. I'm just doing this to keep him weak. I might actually allow him to build that building. Might as well let him build that for me. I think it's a trading post. Not gonna hurt having one more of those. Okay, and then I wanted a scout. I'll go and scavenge that. And we do need a brewery. Let's upgrade this. And then down here, I would like to get the thingy. So let's build a. We need to mine the iron first. Oh, but we can build two buildings here. So we can build a silo and a brewery here. So we get the brewery once we have 100 more. Greater trade routes. Coinage. I think we go for mining efficiency. Go up the economic tree a little bit. Okay, so he has built these buildings for me, so now I can go and take over that area. And he has his war chief now. Just gotta keep that in mind. I wanna build that brewery first though. So, Mr. Scout, you go and explore here. Let's take this. Not sure if I want a trading post. I want this. I think I'm gonna not keep the trading post. I'd rather have this area to build something else if I need it. So we have a lot of wood. So that's a lot of stone. Go build this so we can get some heaviness. Oh, he was defeated. Don't have enough to get this area, unfortunately. Be nice though. Another train camp, a house, a healer's hut, some more runestone. I think I'm gonna end this first video here, so I hope you enjoyed. If you did, consider the like button, subscribing. This one has definitely been a bit of a tougher one, so let's see how that looks next time. So hope you join me for that. Bye bye.